Hi, welcome to the Woodcraft Woodshop. Today I'd like to take a few moments to introduce you to the Resin Casting Pressure Pot from California Air Tools. This pot is specifically designed for resin casting. Some of the great features and benefits that's been built into this pot is it is ready to use out of the box. The only assembly that has to be done on this are your casters, if you so choose to put those on. Other than that, it is plug and play. All right, so the first step, once you take it out of the box, you always want to inspect your gasket. Make sure that it is properly seated in the channel, that it's clean and free of any debris. The other thing that you'll want to do is check the rim of the pot. Make sure that it is clean, free of debris, that there's nothing that's going to interfere with a perfect tight seal for when you're adding the pressure to the pot. All right, I've mixed up a couple of blanks. I've got one here that is designed for bottle stoppers, and I've got another one that's designed for handle stock material, so I've got some knives I'm going to be making here later. So I'm going to make some custom acrylics for that. So it's very simple. All we do is set the molds down inside the tank. We're going to install our lid. We're going to fasten our bolts, and we're going to do this by hand. We're not going to need to put it in a huge amount of pressure on these. These are going to be hand tight. When I do this, I generally like to do it as I would on a car tire. So I'm going to start on one side and rotate back and forth. So we're just going to check these, make sure everything's tightened down. So we've got the tank loaded. The first step that we're going to do is we're going to pull the knob on the regulator and rotate counterclockwise till it stops. Reason we're doing this is when we go to introduce pressure into the tank, instead of introducing 35 to 40 pounds of pressure all at once, which is going to splatter resin all over the inside of your pot, we'll slowly introduce the pressure to the tank, bring it up to pressure, and this avoids that possibility of making a mess inside your tank. So we're going to connect our air hose, we're going to open our valve, and we're going to start rotating the pressure regulator knob until we hear that air being introduced in the tank. So we're going to slowly introduce the air into the tank. And I'm going to recommend that you check with your manufacturer's instructions as to what pound rating is recommended for the curing process. The product that I use, which is Alumilite, generally anywhere between 35 to 40 pounds is what's recommended on their product. So we're going to slowly introduce that air. And again, what this is doing by the introduction of air onto the resin and into the molds is it's compressing all the air that is inside that resin. And it's going to give you a bubble-free blank when it's all said and done. So we're in between that 35 to 40 PSI. So we're going to turn our valve off, disconnect our air hose, and we'll set our timer and come back and open the pot once it's all done. All right, it's time. So let's bleed the air off the tank. And to do that, you have an adjustable pitcock on the back. So we're going to rotate that counterclockwise and slowly bleed the air off the tank. We're going to bleed that off completely until our regulator gauge shows zero, before we loosen the bolts off the lid. Okay, pressure's been bled, gauge is at zero, so we're gonna undo the bolts. take a look at what we got. I love, love, love the lizard blank molds. These are made from ultra high molecular plastics. These are reusable, easy to put together, easy to take apart. They're a dovetailed product that just releases the blanks. So that's one of them. I hope you've enjoyed taking a look at the Resin Casting Pressure Pot from California Air. Be sure to pick one up at your local Woodcraft or at woodcraft.com. Thank you and have a great day.